Okay, so here we are again at Cockenzie. I'm doing this little jug of marguerite daisies, I think they are. I've just done changing my water, done a bit of jumping about and shaking it off, and in fact even making weird noises. Someone came in, actually, it was a bit embarrassing. But it's kind of loosened me up a bit. And if you're coming to the workshop next week, prepare to be loosened up. Because I think I'm going to lead the group in a bit of shaking it off before we start. I think that would be helpful. Because it helps me. It's good to kind of be presented with challenges and try to overcome them, you know. Because I think it gives me ideas too for what to do in my workshops. Okay, so I've got the clean water. And now I've moved you to the other side. I don't know if it's better or worse, but it is what it is. Let's see now. I'm trying to find it. Kitchen paper. It's quite a contraption. Like, I've set you up with my boot and on top of a box with my boot to the back so that you're straighter. Yeah, I don't know. So what's going to happen now is I'm going to focus on focusing, actually, just to stop talking to myself about things and just to focus on what is actually here. That's what I'm going to do right now. So with my eyes half closed, there's a bright petal that extends down below the jug. One bright one that covers the jug here, and it comes to a bit of a point there. It's a nice bright one, so I might end up putting some more blue around it to emphasize it further. And then there's this one here. And again, with my eyes half closed, it's particularly light at the edges. And then there's a couple that are extending over to cover the handle of it. Oh, they do come quite far over. And I think this one needs maybe a little bit longer. And again, I will probably make more of that blue, cerulean blue kind of mix in order to paint the jug up to meet these lights. And then there's a lovely bright bit between two petals here, kind of a channel coming up from the centre of the daisy. It's quite light. And I'll keep going with it. Let's see now. Still half closed eyes. Still with the white from the tube and the brush. And trying to locate the position of the brightest bits of this daisy here. Of making a bit more of that grey colour that I used for the petals too, the shadow grey. It's really a mix of everything in the palette now that I'm using for that, but it looks like the colour I'm after, so I'm going to trust that it'll be fine. I don't know what I made it from, there's loads of different colours in the palette there that made that daisy petal. Just trying to kind of cajole this one into life a little bit. I'd say I'll carry on with some of the cerulean blue here as well, because I do like the interaction between the petals and the jug. There's a nice shape in the space there. In between these two petals, there's a kind of a clear geometric shape that's quite pleasing. And it comes down like that. And it extends around this petal a little bit. And then there's a bit of a gap before we get to the other one. It's like a triangular shape there. So that's... and that feels like then the edge of the jug might be there-ish. I think it's okay. I don't really need to define the edge that hugely. Okay. Remembering to breathe. Softness in the belly. Softness in the muscles of the face. One of the meditations I do some mornings is about smiling. Just to sense a smile in your heart even. And in a big blue sky, to sense a big smile. It's a Tara Brach meditation. I'd recommend it actually. And she does sometimes say to actually smile as well yourself. Like, just to lift the corners of the mouth a little bit. And lift the corners of the eyes. Sometimes I can't bring myself to do that in the midst of the day, but in the morning it seems like an easy enough thing to catch myself, to give myself a good big smile. It's a nice way to begin the day. What am I doing? I'm trying to get a bit more grey to kind of define, what petal is that? It's a kind of chubby, this one has kind of got a wider middle to it. And this one does. Anyway, I'm doing some sort of faffing around, but it seems to be getting me places eventually, kind of thing. Grappling. Some paintings you grapple with, don't you? Some days you grapple with. And you do well just to stay afloat. And then the other days then, when everything, like yesterday, everything opened up and it felt like a breeze. And maybe it's a lesson to me too that I love. I mean, you're helping me here now by interacting with you, but maybe it's a lesson to me too that I love people, really. And, you know, hanging out with Norma yesterday felt really lovely, and passing on things that I find helpful when I'm painting. I love that whole thing. And that's, I suppose, why I kind of do the videos as well, because I like the creative conversations around ways to explain what you want to pull out. And I want to pull out the joyful expression of this daisy, the brightness of it, the joy of that bright white, all these crumpled kind of petals that are shining really. Okay, find the shape of the space between those two. There we are. Because, you know, you can kind of be broken down a bit by life sometimes, can't you? And it takes, I think it was Jonathan who said, sometimes it takes all the energy you've got to live within the life that you have. Something like that. And